Some people think that UDP sucks, at least when compared to TCP, but that's not true. UDP is actually the ideal Layer 4 protocol for three categories of applications. Let me show you. Hello everyone, my name is Ed Harmouche. Welcome to another video in the TCP and UDP Masterclass. In this video, we're going to focus on UDP. We're going to discuss and illustrate the three types of applications that really only make sense with UDP. We're going to do this because we spent the last two videos talking about all the cool things that TCP does, and by contrast, all the things that UDP does not do. Some people will hear about all the cool things that TCP does, and perhaps understandably get the idea that UDP sort of sucks. But that's not true. UDP is actually pretty cool. In fact, there are certain applications that are really not a good fit for TCP and are instead a much better fit for UDP. There are three of them, and we'll be discussing each of them in this lesson. First type of application that is a better fit for UDP than it is for TCP is applications that have small requests and small responses. A good example of this would be DNS. DNS, or the domain name system, is a protocol that's used to resolve domain names to IP addresses. An example DNS conversation looks like this. The client is going to ask for the IP address for a particular domain, in this case, site.com, and the server is going to provide that IP address. That's it. That's the entire conversation. The entire conversation of DNS took only two packets. By comparison, if we did this same conversation over TCP, you'd have to first start out with the three-way handshake. Then the client would make its request, and the server would confirm reception of that request. Then the server would send its response, and of course the client would confirm reception of the response. And finally, one side would have to close their side of the connection, and then the other side would have to do the same, and then you'd be finished with the DNS conversation. Notice the whole thing took 11 packets. If we are doing DNS over TCP, it's going to require 11 packets compared to just two. Now, some of you might be thinking, but wait a minute, sure it takes more packets, but don't you get all the additional benefits of reliability that TCP provides? Sure, but if you're really concerned with reliability for a conversation this small, you can just simply send this twice every single time, or even three times every single time. That would put a total of six packets on the wire and give you three times the chance of it going through. That's still less packets than TCP would require for only one request. So with DNS, since every single request and response typically is less than 300 bytes and most often fit inside a single packet, it's much easier to do that over UDP and spare yourself from the additional burden required by TCP. Now, DNS is just one example. There are many other protocols that fit into this category. Here are just a few. NTP, or the Network Time Protocol, an example conversation of NTP is essentially, hey, what time is it? This is the time. That's it. Very straightforward. SNMP, or Simple Network Management Protocol, is a protocol that lets you pull servers or devices to get information from them. And the conversation is effectively, hey, is such and such interface up? Yes, it's up, or no, it's not. That's it. That's easier to do on UDP than it is for TCP. DHCP is also in this category, but requires a few more packets. You have a discover message looking for a DHCP server, an offer sent by the server providing an IP address, a request sent by the client to officially request for the IP address, and finally, an acknowledgement from the DHCP server acknowledging the claiming of that IP address. That's DHCP. And again, it's only these four packets for the entire conversation, and it's easier to do that over UDP than it would be for TCP. Syslog is another example, but Syslog's conversation is also a little bit different. Syslog isn't necessarily a back and forth conversation type protocol. It's instead a protocol that allows a client to send a bunch of messages to a server whenever notable events have occurred. Each of those events typically can be sent in a single packet. And since often you have many different clients all sending syslog messages to the same server, it doesn't make sense to establish full bidirectional TCP communication with each of those clients. So that is the first type of application that really makes more sense on UDP than it does TCP. Once again, that is applications with small requests and small responses. The second type of application that is better suited for UDP than it is TCP is applications that have their own built-in delivery confirmation system. An example of this would be TFTP. TFTP stands for Trivial File Transfer Protocol. It's a protocol you can use to transfer files amongst different servers. But wait a minute, wouldn't you want reliability for file transfers? I mean, what good is 99% of a file? Well, those are great questions. Let's talk about it. Here is a packet capture using Wireshark of a TFTP conversation. We have the client with a .253 IP address asking for a particular file, and then the server with a .10 IP address sending that file. This first packet is the server sending the first block of that file. Notice the second packet is the client confirming reception of that first block. In fact, notice throughout that conversation, every time the server sends a block of data in that file, the client is acknowledging reception of that block. So you see, TFTP within the TFTP application itself has its own confirmation system. Notice the protocol stack does not have TCP. We are not using TCP for this transfer. This transfer is happening over UDP, and these confirmations are happening within the TFTP application itself. So you see, TFTP has its own acknowledgement system for data delivery. Therefore, we don't need to use TCPs. In fact, using multiple reliability mechanisms ends up being redundant. Both mechanisms end up working against each other. What will inevitably happen is a packet will be dropped, and then both mechanisms will ask for that packet again. And then the sender will send it once to acknowledge the application's reliability system, and once again to acknowledge TCPs. So they end up kind of working against each other. That is why if you have an application with a built-in delivery confirmation system, that application should be done over UDP instead of TCP. Now, TFTP is just one example. There are many others. Here are just a few. RTP, or the Real-Time Transport Protocol, also has their own delivery confirmation system built into the application itself. So does SNMP, or the Simple Network Management Protocol. And there's one more that I want to draw your attention to, since it's going to become pretty significant. That is QUIC. QUIC is sort of the evolution of TCP. It's redoing all the cool things of TCP in a modern way, accounting for all the lessons we've learned about TCP over the last 40 years. Well, since QUIC has its own delivery confirmation system built into QUIC, there's no reason to do QUIC over TCP. That's why QUIC is done over UDP. QUIC is just another example of one of the many applications that have their own built-in confirmation system and is therefore a much better choice for UDP than they are TCP. The third type of application that is better fit for UDP is any application that involves live or streamed content. An example of this would be VoIP, or Voice over IP. VoIP is actually a set of protocols that all serve the purpose of carrying voice or phone calls over IP data packets. This allows you to have a phone call over the internet. But wait a minute, phone calls can be pretty important, right? Wouldn't you want the reliability of TCP for your phone calls? Well, yes, but let me explain. Most of the time, if a simple word is dropped, the listener infers from context the missed word. Imagine how annoying it would be if every time a word was dropped, the VoIP phone call would stop and try to repeat from the last word confirmed to have been received. Most of the time, if a simple word is dropped, the listener can infer from context the missed word. Imagine how annoying it would be if every time a word was dropped, the VoIP phone call would stop and try to repeat from the last word that was confirmed to have been received. See what I mean? Hopefully, that example was an illustration of why live or streamed content is a better fit for UDP. VoIP is, of course, just one example, but here are others. RTP, again, Real-Time Transfer Protocol. SRTP, the secure version of RTP. SIP and H323, all of these are phone calls that contribute to the set of protocols that are VoIP. But beyond just protocols, I want to talk to you about applications themselves. Most software we use today doesn't simply use one network protocol. So conceptually, this third category might be better suited for something like this. Anything that involves live TV or potential multiplayer games, all are examples that fit into this third category. Really, any situation you're in when the latest, real-time, closest to live packet is more important than an older drop packet, that is when you are in a situation that this third category is going to fall within. For example, if you're watching the World Cup or the Super Bowl, or you're playing some competitive multiplayer video game, inevitably you're going to have a drop packet. That drop packet sucks, but at the same time, you'd much rather focus on the most recent events than you would figuring out what happened to that one drop packet. So those types of situations are typically better suited for UDP, because UDP, unlike TCP, is not going to stop and figure out what happened to that one drop packet. UDP is always going to concern itself with the most recent packet, the one that's closest to live and real time. So that is an example of the third type of application that makes the most sense with UDP. So that's it. That's our discussion of the three types of applications that are better fit for UDP than they are for TCP. Hopefully now, at the end of this video, that you've come to realize that UDP does not suck at all. In fact, UDP is pretty awesome. And hopefully, the last couple videos in this series tell you that TCP also doesn't suck. TCP is awesome. They're both awesome, and they are both awesome for different reasons. There are certain applications that are a much better fit for UDP, and other applications that are a much better fit for TCP. The main takeaways from this lesson are to understand the three types of applications which are better suited for UDP than they are for TCP. If you have any questions and want to learn more about TCP or UDP, let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, don't forget to smash that notification bell and subscribe to that like button, or something like that. Thank you for watching this video, and we'll see you in the next one.